So what even is a composable CDP? Composable CDP and this general idea of composability are one of the hottest words across MarTech right now. There's a lot of people flocking towards composable CDPs as the next big thing. There's a lot of companies that are claiming to be delivering great value from composable CDPs. And there's a lot of us that are just sitting around confused on what the heck a composable CDP is. What is it? How does it work technically? How does it compare to a traditional CDP that every other vendor is trying to sell me? And when should I be considering a composable CDP? Before I give a deep dive into really what a composable CDP is, I wanted to take a minute or so to just talk about what a CDP is in the first place. So a CDP is an end-to-end platform to help you manage your customer data for the purpose of using it towards your marketing. And when I say using your data towards marketing, I mean things like improving your targeting, personalization, orchestrating really cool customer journeys across different platforms. The promise CDP solved was awesome. The ability to collect all your data, manage it, store it, activate it in a central platform sounds amazing, but it was kind of the only solution around. Companies didn't have another place where they were dumping all their data into. Something changed over the last 5 to 10 years, which was that the data warehouses have always existed in some way, shape, or form. You know, there's been data warehouse technologies for decades at this point, but these data warehouses got a lot better. They just became a lot more scalable, and using these data warehouse platforms was just a lot easier and a lot faster than it was back in the day. And because of these technological advancements, data warehouses are being used all over the place. So the whole premise of a composable CDP is very simple. It basically says for companies that are investing in a data warehouse or planning to make a shift towards a data warehouse being the center of gravity for data in their organization, there's maybe no point of buying a separate CDP that's going to be a separate data store and almost a separate data warehouse and putting all your customer information to there. Instead, the idea of a composable CDP is to bring CDP functionality directly to your data warehouse. Instead of going into a third-party system like Segment or Salesforce CDP or Adobe CDP and building audiences and, you know, sending data to different tools from their database, you can set CDP functionality with a composable CDP directly on top of your data warehouse, like your Snowflake, where your company already has a ton of data. And why is this approach interesting to companies at all? For a lot of companies, their data warehouse is already kind of their CDP. And that's not like totally true, right? It doesn't make total sense. There's no audience builder, there's no identity resolution capabilities, et cetera, with CDP. What I mean by that is that companies already have a ton of data in their data warehouse. So the idea of being able to buy a platform from like a composable CDP that can sit directly on top of that warehouse is really, really appealing when it comes to time to value of a solution like a CDP. So being able to spin it up super, super fast. The other advantage that I see a lot of companies talking about is the fact that composable CDPs are more flexible when it comes to actually managing customer data. You know, traditional CDPs like a Segment or a Salesforce usually have a schema by which your data needs to follow, like a certain format. So, you know, users should be tracked this way, then users can take events. Maybe they have an account object that they can support if, you know, they also work with B2B companies, but they have random rules on those data sets, like users can only be in one account. When it comes to data warehousing, you have one of the most flexible systems ever for managing data. Obviously, that can come with a bit more complexity, but if your company's already using something like Snowflake, you can have all sorts of data in it. You can have tables for product inventory, loyalty systems, web traffic, users, data science models, machine learning, really anything you can imagine can be in a data warehouse. And what that means is that composable CDPs have actually built their software in a way that they can sit on top of all these data models and make it really easy for companies to run queries and build audiences like, find me all the users who are in a household with a pet, which we track in our loyalty system, with a birthday coming up. And in a traditional CDP, it's often hard to build audiences like that or build personalization like that because you're limited to this kind of cookie cutter format of users and events, which made sense if you're just getting started, but maybe it doesn't allow you to do as flexible of personalization as you really want. Another reason that composable CDPs are taking off is that they actually have this kind of unique architecture when it comes to SaaS software. It's not really something we've seen across any SaaS tool, whether it's a CRM, an advertising tool, or a marketing automation system, let alone a CDP, which is that they don't actually have to store your data. So since you have all your data inside of something like Snowflake, composable CDPs actually sit directly on top of those data warehouses and use the data warehouse as their backend, which actually means they don't have to store a copy of your data. And this is really important in the growing age of privacy and InfoSec concerns, security breaches and whatnot, especially in industries like financial services and healthcare, but even in companies that just operate globally where every region you operate in, whether it's Europe, US, India, Japan, has its own sort of data regulation and privacy laws. And the last reason I would say is that composable CDPs are modular. And there's a lot of different words for modular that you'll probably see online if you're researching composable CDPs. Some people say they're interoperable. Some people say say they're composable. Some people say they're unbundled. But what this really, really means is that composable CDPs provide functionality where you can pick and choose what you need. In the end of the day, for an enterprise company that's thinking about their customer data, it's not all going to happen in this one off-the-shelf solution that they buy. A lot of companies already have good tools to collect data into the warehouse, in which case you don't have to buy that kind of functionality of how to collect event data from your websites and mobile apps into the warehouse from a composable CDP. But if you do want that functionality, you can buy it from a composable CDP. So it's kind of an approach that allows you to buy each part of the CDP as different components based on what your organization really needs, whether that's event collection, identity resolution, audience building, integrations, and whatnot. So it's not harder because you can still buy it from one company, but you can buy each part individually, which, you know, reduces the amount of shelfware you have or just, you know, exorbitant bills for only using a part of the platform, which is kind of a common problem across MarTech that Composable aims to solve. What about implementation? A composable CDP sounds awesome, but also sounds like it could be a lot of work. A couple things to keep in mind. One, there's no such thing as magic when it comes to technology. There's just technology. There's always some sort of implementation work to use any type of solution. With a CDP, the implementation work is actually collecting your data from your websites, from your mobile apps, from your backends in the format of the CDP. So there's actually kind of software engineering work or developer work that you have to assign your teams to do internally in order to stand up a CDP and to start building audiences. And, you know, this process can take anywhere between 6 to 12 months in an enterprise. With a composable CDP, you're not doing engineering work to, you know, go recollect all your data, unless that's something you need to do, in which case a lot of composable CDPs do provide kind of event collection functionality. There's a myth that goes around, which is that to use a composable CDP, you have to be a super advanced organization that has everything in your data warehouse, has it all prettied up and cleaned up. One thing I've just found over the years working in data is that a lot of times there's, you know, low-hanging fruit use cases in businesses that can be solved without doing a lot of the prerequisite steps of getting all your data in order. So that's one thing I would just keep in mind as you explore any sort of MarTech or data solution. But the big thing is that this is really no longer true. In the early days, composable CDP solutions just focused on things like activation or reverse ETL. So taking data from the warehouse, bringing it to different places around your organization. But as they've evolved, they've become all basically, you know, complete platforms that live on top of the data warehouse that offer products that solve all the CDP concerns, but in a way that's way more flexible. So composable CDPs have actually evolved to be a kind of a more complete product, but still composable.